Assalamualaikum and a very good day to all. My name is Sabarina binti Muhammad Shah and I'm a lecturer from Accounting and Finance Department, Faculty of Economics and Management. Today, what we're going to do is that we're going to look at the client's business and processes in a revenue transaction. To begin with, if you were to look at the financial statements, under income statements or statements of comprehensive income, the first line item is revenue. Remember, a business is set up in order to generate revenue and to be able to sustain in the industry in which the business operates. There are a variety of business in which operates in different industries. These include, among others, companies involved in merchandising, manufacturing and services. In which operates in industry, for instance, the agriculture, oil and gas, real estates, tourism, information technology, and so forth. It is very important for students to understand, first, the client's business and the industry in which the business operates. Second, the business processes, for example, revenue, purchasing. Hence, students must put themselves as the business operators which eventually place themselves as preparers of the financial statements. A poster is provided that outlines the business processes involved in recognizing revenue by business operators, interchangeably known as the clients. The revenue transactions are initiated by the receipt of customer order from customer. Throughout the business processes in respect of revenue transactions, there are controls measures that must take place. The first control that should take place is checking the customer's credibility before granting credit by sales department. Now, why is this internal control important? The answer is to ensure the business operators only approve customers who have a healthy financial position. This is to ensure business operators are able to receive payments for the products that they have sold or for the services that they have rendered. This is very important for, if left unchecked, there may be bad debts. In extreme cases, it's going to affect the liquidity of the business entity. But that is a business risk. What has it got to do with auditor, an external auditor? We will KIV that question. Hope you will be able to answer this once you have completed the part on auditing clients' business and processes. Throughout the business processes, you need to acknowledge the fact that it is management responsibility to first mitigate risk that is peculiar to their business and industry which they operate. Second, mitigate risk of not being able to provide reliable financial reporting. Therefore, it is very, very important for management to have their own internal controls through the establishment of sound policies and procedures and to implement these effectively and efficiently, or else the repercussion could be very severe. Examples are as follows. A salesperson may overstate sales to improve the likelihood of receiving bonus. Employees in the receiving area may be too busy to accurately record delivery of inventory. Management may have not exercised appropriate judgment and may have overvalued its assets. Now, there is a need to acknowledge that the most widely used framework in the United States and around the world is the Internal Control Integrated Framework published by the Committee of Sponsoring Organizations of the Trade Commissions. It was first introduced in 1992, then in 2013 it has been revised and enhanced and now called COSO Internal Control Integrated Framework, simply known as COSO. Okay. We will not go into the details. This will be discussed in the class. Make sure you go through the poster and also cross-reference with your auditing books and understand what are the controls that should be in place in a revenue transaction. Next, there is a need to know how and when do revenue is recognized by the clients. In Malaysia context, there is a need to refer to Malaysian Accounting Standard Board, MFRS 15. Which Malaysia has adopted from the International Accounting Standards Board, IFRS 15, which is actually effective from 31st December 2018.